Did you know that the most brutal punishment carried out by the Vikings was called the Blood Eagle? The Vikings ordinarily were by no means merciful towards their enemies, but this punishment was still considered so taboo that it was reserved for very special occasions. First, a blade such as a knife or an axe was used to slice all the way from the top of the spine down to the tailbone. Then the folds of skin were pulled aside to expose the ribs from the back. The ribs would then be detached from the backbone and the lungs pulled through the opening to resemble a pair of eagle's wings. If at this point you somehow still weren't dead from shock, pain or blood loss, the crows would soon take care of the rest. According to near-contemporary Danish sagas, the highest profile individual to fall victim to the Blood Eagle was King Ella of Northumbria, who was executed by Blood Eagle shortly after he killed Ragnar Lothbrok. You know you messed up when you get given a punishment that even the Vikings think is too far.
The craziest torture methods ever, part 31. Immurement. The horrific act of locking someone in closed quarters, such as sealing them into a wall like this, or in a coffin or box. This one has been around for centuries and used on almost every continent. This was typically a form of capital punishment, but was also used in human sacrifice, mainly to bring good fortune to those doing the sacrificing. You could be in there for hours, weeks, days, months you didn't know. To make sure it lasted, someone would bring you food and water, but it was all too common for you to be completely forgotten about, left there to rot. Fuck that. The craziest torture devices ever, part 39. The Kang. Used in ancient China as a form of torture and public humiliation. A large flat wooden board would be bolted to your neck, usually displaying on paper the crimes you committed. The size and weight of the board depended on the severity of your crime. Some weighed up to 200 pounds. This would leave you unable to lie down comfortably or even feed yourself. The victim would typically have to beg someone to feed them. Death via starvation was all too common. Fuck that. The craziest torture devices ever, part 36. The Whirligig, used as a military punishment by the British Army in the 1700s. It was a 6-foot-tall cylindrical cage with pivots on the top and bottom. For hours, even sometimes a full day, they would violently spin you around. Used as torture, punishment, and public humiliation. As you can imagine, this caused extreme nausea and even victims falling unconscious. This one may not be deadly, but isn't it ridiculous? Now, I hate being dizzy, so this device earns a big fat fuck that. The craziest torture methods ever, part 28. Marooning. This is the act of abandoning someone in an uninhabited area. The word first appears in writing in 1709, used on crew members and captains accused of mutiny. They would usually leave you with a tiny amount of food and water, and a loaded handgun if suicide was desired. I didn't classify this as execution because a lot of people did survive. But just imagine how bad that would suck having a Tom Hanks your ass out there on a fucking island. You know what I say to marooning? Fuck that. The craziest torture methods ever, part 27. Peineforte de dur. That's actually French for strong and harsh punishment. This was actually a legal law torture method, introduced in the 1400s and abolished in the 1800s. This was only used for defendants who refused to enter a plea or stood mute. Heavy weights or stones would be applied to the chest of the victim. More and more weight would be added until a plea was entered or death resulted. This could go on for days. Fuck that.
Medieval torture device, part 13. This punishment for a crime was very popular in China, and sometimes it would start like this: taking the prisoner around town, showing people what can happen if you commit crimes. And it would end like so. Strong horses would be tied to the person's arms and legs, and they would be given a command to run in different directions. The horses would then be strong enough to pull the person apart.
2,000 years ago, the Chinese Han Dynasty would punish nobility that had committed a crime by tickling their feet with a feather, since it would leave no physical marks. The ancient Romans used the same method to punish their criminals, but they would instead dip the criminal's feet in salt, tie the person up, and have a goat lick the salt off their feet. This version was a bit more painful.
I'm so pretty and he like that. When he beat it up, he deep inside that kitty cat. Kitty cat, losing.